Filmmaker Wes Anderson begins the plot of the story by a book writer that is visiting the Grand Budapest Hotel. He is trying to figure out why the hotel has become less popular. On his journey to discovering the history, he meets the owner unexpectedly. Zero, the owner, invites him to dinner to uncover the story he has been longing for. Zero begins his story with Gustav, his friend, mentor, and the one in charge of the hotel. As Zero continues to tell his story, he reveals his adventures, journey, and love that the hotel has given him. Filmmaker Wes Anderson builds an extraordinary cinematic feel through color and symmetric shots of the camera. Anderson films are known for his unique style of shooting and can be right away noticed. Wes films have somewhat of a cartoon feel and 2D style, but each shot, color, and rhythm are used to their full potential to tell an effective story, not only through a great script, but also through great visual. So what I'm going to be talking about is going to be four components, which is going to be sound, visual, and movement and rhythm. I think Anderson uses these four components really well in this film that really tell the story more effectively. If he would not have these four components in this movie, I think this movie would not have been as effective as it was. Start off with sound.
And so my life began. Junior lobby boy in training, Grand Budapest Hotel, under the strict command of Monsieur Gustave.
This film gives more of a folky, musical sound to it. And it really relates to the film because this film is more like a cartoon-like. Each of them have their own like kind of musical theme. Take for example Gustav, who is in charge of the hotel and runs the hotel and keeps it going. And you can tell by his character, he takes his job seriously. He likes to flirt with the older ladies. He has relations with them, and he's very modest and carries himself very professionally. Secondly, I'm gonna go into visual. Visual, what is the visual block in this film? It's the props that they use, the costume that they use, the scenery, where the scenery was taken at. And we can see that this scenery is very cartoon-like. Again, you can see the beginning of the video where they show the hotel, and it looks kind of like a 2D fake hotel that really is on a mountain, like unrealistic feel of this film. And once you go inside, you can see that it really is real, and everybody is wearing the bright colors, wearing like magenta colors, like the purple. People wearing the little hats make them look kind of, you know, goofy, kind of like if you're watching like a little cartoon for kids. You get this visual throughout the film and everywhere they go. Take for example in the hotel, you see the elevators, the colors that they are put out there, the pink, the purple, and you see where they're going through doors. It kind of reminds me like a sort of like Blue Clues kind of images as well, or films or stories. You can also do a very visual one that looks really fake is when they're doing the chase in the snow, and you can tell that, you know, it's obviously fake because no one goes that fast without crashing, or no one goes that fast in the film. So the film really uses these visuals to kind of portray the comedy and really set the mood to people to not take this seriously and really, you know, just focus on what's going on and what's gonna happen next. Now, the third topic is movement. And movement is just the first visual components that attract the eye. Movement can occur using the objects, to the camera, or the viewer's eyes as they watch the screen. And you see this throughout the film. You see, as you know, in the beginning when Gustav is looking outside the window, and then out of a sudden he turns around and he walks, and you see the camera movement not turning in front of him, not turning behind him, but walking with him as he, staying with him as he walks. And he walks through the walls, and he continues to take that movement, and really that pace gives the momentum of what's happening next. The movements to these cameras give the character who they are and really portrays them and how they work within the movie, how they act within the movie, and who the character is throughout this movie through the movement of the camera. And you can see this through each character as the movement for each character is put. But mostly you see throughout this film that the movements are just, they're either panning right or panning left, but the camera stays with the character at all time. It's rarely if you see the camera moving without the character and following it, but most of the time you'll see that the camera is moving with the character or is at the center, which gives that non-movement, which really describes what is happening in that moment. Lastly, rhythm. We are most familiar with rhythm. We can hear it, but there's also rhythm we can see. Rhythm is found in stationary non-movement objects, moving objects, and editing. So we can see the rhythm here through this movie all the time, like crazy. We can see rhythm through, we can hear rhythm through the dialogue.
Experience. Hotel Kinski, kitchen boy, 6 months. Hotel Berlitz, mop and broom boy, 3 months.
You can hear their dialogue, each of them talk according to how they move. If you see it, their rhythm follows their voice, their voice follows how fast they talk, to how they look, how they dress. Everything is aligned with their rhythm. And we can see this through objects, like if they're driving a car, if they're driving, we see Zero when he's driving the sleigh. We see when the antagonist, the way they speak, the way they talk, the way they move, we see rhythm happening constantly in this film. Wes Anderson is an amazing film director. He filmed this movie and did an awesome job. If you happen to run into other films that Wes Anderson has made, make sure to see these four components, and that is the visual storytelling.